Hello, welcome. Let us the chapter locus. Already we have discussed some cases how to find the locus of the given point, locus of a point in different situations, and also we have learned the theorems based on locus. And today let us have some more situations, how to describe the locus and how to draw the locus. Your first one is, draw and describe the locus of vertices of all isosceles triangles having a common base. Isosceles triangles having a common base. What is the locus of vertices of all isosceles triangles? Question asked. Okay. So let me draw the isosceles triangles having a common base first. Okay. You know that in an isosceles triangle, two sides are equal, okay? Having a common base. May not be exactly same, but I am trying to help you out. These are the isosceles triangles having the common base. Okay. Let me name this as A, B, C, D, E, F. Triangle ABC, triangle DBC, triangle EBC, triangle FBC are the isosceles triangles on the same base. BC, you have to find and also draw, describe the locus of vertices, means vertex of triangle ABC is A, vertex of triangle DBC is D, vertex of triangle EBC is E, vertex of angle FBC is F. What is the locus of all the vertices of these isosceles triangles having the common base? That means when you join all these, you will get the perpendicular bisector of BC. You know that in an isosceles triangle, the perpendicular bisects the base. So, when you join all these vertices of isosceles triangle, the locus will be the perpendicular bisector of BC, of the base. Okay? So, the question is I have drawn. Describe. So, the locus of vertices of all the isosceles having a common base is, oh, question only I am containing, is the perpendicular bisector of the common base or base. Okay, question concluded. For means I have joined the question only, I have continued the answer here. Okay, now second situation. Draw and describe the locus of points inside a circle at equidistant from two fixed points on the circle. Suppose this is a circle. These are the two fixed points A and B. What is the locus of points inside a circle equidistant from two fixed points on the circle? So, A and B are the two fixed points on the circle. Already you have learned that the locus of points equidistant from two fixed points is the perpendicular bisector of the line segments joining the two points. So, let me join this A and B. Okay. And you know that the perpendicular bisector, now what happens? AB became the chord of the circle. Okay. So, the perpendicular bisector of AB will pass through the diameter. Will pass through the diameter. Okay, that you are going to learn in circle chapter. For now, you can understand this. The perpendicular bisector of the chord, any chord of the circle, passes through the center. That means, these two will be equal and this will be perpendicular. So the locus of points inside a circle and equidistant from two points on the circle is the diameter of the circle. Diameter of the circle perpendicular, this is the diameter. We have infinite number of diameters in a circle, but the diameter of the circle which is perpendicular to the line segment joining the two points. Joining the two points. You cannot write to any other diameter. Okay. I hope this is clear to you. So two situations I have explained you. Let me explain you few more. So your third situation is, draw and describe the locus of a point in the rhombus ABCD which is equidistant from AB and AD. So let me draw rhombus ABCD. So ABCD is a rhombus. You know that in a rhombus all the sides are equal. You have to find the locus of a point which is equidistant from AB and AD. That means equidistant from AB and AD is the bisector of angle BAD. And you know that in a rhombus the diagonal bisects each angle. Okay. So here the locus will be the diagonal AC. So the locus of a point in rhombus ABCD which is equidistant from AB and AD is the diagonal AC. Is the diagonal AC. Children, I am not writing again the question. You have to continue that. Okay. Now your fourth next question is, find the locus, draw and describe the locus of center of a circle of varying radius and touching two arms of angle ABC. Let me draw angle ABC. Suppose this is angle ABC. You have to find the locus of the center of a circle of varying radius touching the two arms of the circle, arms of the angle. So let me draw different circles touching two arms center. Let me draw one more circle touching center. So like that, if the circles touch the arms of the angle, you will see when you join all these points, this one will be the bisector of angle ABC. When you join all the centers of all the circles which are touching the arms of the angle, you will find that you will get the bisector of angle ABC. Varying diameter touching two arms of angle ABC is the bisector of angle ABC. So children, some situations I have explained you how to draw and describe the locus of some situations. And while you are going through, you will be able to do well. And many more and different kinds of situations are there. By practice, you will be able to do well. Okay. Thank you.